dear students, once again welcome back to our online classes. This is your subject teacher of English from Alpine Public School, which is situated in Golabachar, Gorakhpur. Dear student, in my previous video, I have already explained the poem Butterfly Laughter. And in today's video, I'm going to explain the exercises of this chapter. So first of all, you all take out your new Champs English Reader book and open page number 21. On page number 21, there is a poem, Butterfly Laughter. So dear student, we have already learned this poem. So now we're moving to the exercises, that is exercise A. So what will we do in exercise A? So dear student, there is a exercise A, take the correct meanings of these lines, okay? First of all, we have to read the given lines, and after that, we have to choose the correct meaning of this line, okay? As you can see at your screen, there is a two option of this line, so we have to choose the correct one. Okay, so let's read the number one. In number one, there is an each morning we tried who should raise the butterfly first, and each morning we tried who should raise the butterfly first. So student, there is option number A, age. The children try to catch the butterfly on their porous walls, and option number B is the children tried to be the first to finish their porridge. Okay, so tell me which meaning are correct according to the given lines. So student, here is the option number B is correct according to the lines, that is the children tried to be the first to finish their porridge. Okay, so we have to take the option number B. Now moving to the next, there is a second. Next is the grandmother said, there is a second, then the grandmother said, do not eat the poor butterfly. So student, what the meaning of these given lines? So again, here is a two option. Option number A is, the grandmother was afraid that hungry children would eat the butterfly. And option number B is, the grandmother joked that the hungry children would eat the butterfly. So tell me which one is correct, which option is correct according to the lines. So student, there is a option number B is correct. The meaning of this given lines, the grandmother's joke that the hungry children would eat the butterfly. So we have to take the option number B. Now moving to the next, number third. That is, always she said it and always it started us laughing. Always she said it and always it started us laughing. So what the meaning of this given lines? So here are again two options. Option number A is, the children laugh because they thought their grandmother was foolish. And option number B is, the children laughed because it was a sweet joke between them and their grandmother. So student, tell me which meaning is correct according to the given lines. So yes, option number B is correct. So we have to take the option number B, that is the children laughed because it was a sweet joke between them and their grandmother. So we have to take the option number B. Okay student, now moving to the next, this is number four. In number four, I was certain that one fine morning the butterfly would fly out of our plates. So what the meaning of this given line? So there is a two option. Option number A is, one day the butterfly would fall into their porous plates. And option number B is, one day the painted butterfly on the plate would come to life. So student, tell me which one is correct, which meaning is correct according to the given lines. So yes, the option number B is correct, that is one day the painted butterfly on the plate would come to life. So we have to take the option number B. Okay student, so like this we have to complete the exercise A. Now we moving to the next exercise, that is exercise B. Student, it's a homework for you, you have to complete it. That what is this? So how do you think the poet feels about her grandmother? Give reason for your answer. Okay student, dear student, you have to write the answer in your own words. Okay, you have to write the answer in your own words before thinking. Okay, you have to think and after that write. Okay dear student, here are some hints for you. You have to use the given hints and after that you have to write answer of this given question, that how do you think the poet feels about her grandmother. Okay, so give reason for your answer. Student, it's your homework, you have to write down. Now we're moving to the next exercise, that is play with words. In exercise B, as you can see, there is a hint for you. Do the children enjoy this joke about the butterfly on the plates, or are they annoyed by it? So, student, here is the hint given for you. You have to choose the correct hint, and after that, you have to think and write that what poet feels about her grandmother. Okay. Now we're moving to the next, that is exercise C. So use these phrases from the poem in sentences of your own. Okay, student? Dear student, we have already discussed about the what is phrases. Do you know what is phrases? So phrase is a small group of words which make a sense but not complete sense. Okay. So here are, we have to use this given phrases from the poem in sentences of your own. So these are the phrases that given in the poem. So you have to use this given phrase and make a new sentences, okay, in your own words. So dear student, it's again your homework for you. So you have to do it. And after that, there is a next stage, compound word. What is compound word? Do you know about it? Yes. So you have to learn it. What is compound word? When two words are joined together to make a new word, it is called a compound word. What is compound word? So we can say that when two words are joined together to make a new word, it is called a compound word. For example, there is a word grand plus mother. So when we add this given word, it becomes grandmother. Okay. So we say that it is example of compound words. Okay, student. So like this, we have to do the exercise D. It's a hint for you. Now you do the next, that is exercise D. In exercise D, match this word to from compound words, write the new words. So first of all, we have to match this given word with their compound word, and after that we have to make new words. So let's do this. So in number one, there is butter. Second is ran. Third is down. Fourth is child. Fifth is under. Sixth is run. So this trend, firstly we have to match this given word with their compound word, okay. And after that, we have to write the new words. So firstly, there is a butter. So we have to match butter with fly. So it will be butterfly. So we have to write butterfly in the below. Okay. Now second word is ran. So we have to match ran with blow. Ran with bow. So it will be rainbow. Firstly, tell me what the spelling of butterfly. So the spelling of butterfly is B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y, butterfly. Second is rainbow. So the spelling of rainbow is... So student, second we write the spelling of rainbow. When we add ran plus bow, it will be rainbow. So what the spelling of rainbow? So the spelling of rainbow is R-A-I-N-B-O-W. Okay? So it will be rainbow. Now the third is down. Third word is down. So when we match down with stairs, so it will be downstair. What the spelling of downstair? We have to match number third with B, that is stairs, and it will be downstairs. What the spelling of downstair? D-O-W-N-S-T-A-I-R-S. Okay, downstairs. Now we're moving to the next word, that is number four. The fourth word is child. So we have to match number four with E, that is hood. So it will be childhood. What the spelling of childhood? C-H-I-L-D-H-O-O-D, hood. Okay, childhood. Now moving to the next word, that is under. So we have to match number 5 with A, that is stood. Understood. It becomes understood. What the spelling of understood? U-N-D-E-R-S-T-O-O-D, understood. Okay, student. Now moving to the next, number 6, that is run. So we have to match number 6 with D, that is wheel. It will be runway. What the spelling of runway? So R-U-N-W-A-Y, runway. So like this, we have to complete this given exercise D. Now we're moving to the next exercise, that is grammar fun for you. So in this exercise, we have to learn about, we will learn about the singular and plural nouns. Dear student, you have already learned about this topic, but one more time, you have to learn this given topic, that is singular noun and plural nouns. Before the knowledge of singular and plural, you tell me, have you know that what is nouns? Noun is a naming words. As we all know that noun is a naming word, the name of any person, people, places, things or animals are called nouns or naming words. Okay, so in nouns we will learn about the singular and plural number. Okay, so first of all there is a singular nouns. What is singular nouns? So nouns that stand for one thing, place, animal or person are called singular noun. It means the words that stand for one thing, place, animals or person are called singular nouns. And what is plural nouns? So plural nouns, nouns that stand for more than one person, place, animals or things are called plural nouns. Plurals are often formed by adding s or es. For example, there is a singular word play, and when we change this singular word into plural it becomes plates by adding es. Next is dress, so it will be dresses in plural form. Okay student, so like this there is a next stage in words that end with y. Here is a more information for you that in words that end with y, plurals are formed by dropping the y and adding ies. For example, there is a butterfly, so it will be in plural form butterflies. Here we drop the y and in place of y we have to use ies. Okay, next word is hobby, so we have to drop y in plural form and it will be hobbies, hobbies, hobbies. Okay student, this is next information is in word that end with f or fe, plurals are formed by dropping the f or fe and adding ves. For example, there is a word leaf in singular form, so it will be we have to drop f and it will be in plural form leaves. Okay, as you can see at your screen that we have using ves. Okay student, now we moving to the next. There is a next example, wife. So here you can see there is a fe, so we have to drop fe and in place of fe we have to use the plural form ves. Okay student, now the next is some nouns remain the same in singular and plural form. For example, ship. So ship is already plural word, it is a singular and plural word. Okay, now the next is seizure, so we can say that it is a singular plural both. Okay, now according to this knowledge we going to solve the exercise E. According to the knowledge of numbers, singular and plural numbers, we're going to solve the given exercise, that is exercise E. So what will we do in exercise E? So dear student, write the plural forms of these words. Okay, so here you can see there is examples of singular, so we have to change this given singular form into plural. Okay, so there is a first is jeans, so it will be in plural jeans. Okay, because it is already plural form. Now next is calf. So student, here you can see there's a last letter is f, so we have to drop f and in place of f we have to use ves. Okay, so it will be calves. Now third is self, so it again selves. Fourth is penny, as you can see there is a y, so we have to drop y and in place of y we have to use ies. Okay, so it will be pennies. Now the next is deer. So student, there is already a plural form, so we have to write the same. Now the next is church, so here we have to use es, it will be churches. Now the next seventh is days, so it will be disage. Now next is life, so here you can see there is a letter fe, so we have to drop fe and in place of fe we have to use ves, so it will be lives. Okay, so like this you have to complete this given exercise E. Now moving to the next, there is a next information about the collective nouns. So dear student, what is collective nouns? Do you know about the collective nouns? So let's learn what is collective nouns. So student, nouns that name a group of or class of things, people or animals are called collective nouns. Nouns that name a group or class of things, people or animals are called collective nouns. A collective noun is always treated as a singular noun. So a pair of dolphins was spotted from the shore this morning. Dear student, here is the definition of collective nouns. It means a noun that name of the name that name a group or class of things, people or animals are called collective nouns. A collective noun is always treated as a singular noun. For example, here you can see there's a first example. A pride of lions lives in this part of the jungle. And next is a pod of dolphins was spotted from the shore this morning. So let's do the given exercise according to the knowledge of collective nouns. Okay, so it is the exercise F. In exercise F, complete these phrases. Choose from the box. You have to choose the correct word according to the given collective words. Okay, student, we have to choose the correct group of word. So first is a dash of wolves. A dash of wolves. So student, we have to write here pack. A pack of wolves. Okay, a pack of wolves. What we call the group of wolves? It will be pack. Okay. Second is a dash of people. So we call the group of people is crowd. A crowd of people. Third is a dash of soldiers. So we have to write here troop. A troop of soldiers. Okay. Next is a dash of fish. A dash of fish. So here we have to write a school of fish. A school of fish. Okay. Fifth is a dash of a gaggle of geese. Okay, a gaggle of geese. Now the next is a dash of singers. So a choir of singers. Okay, students, like this we have to complete this exercise F. So dear student, I hope is that clear to you that how could you complete this given exercises in your book. Now student, you have to write this exercise A in your notebook and also learn the what is compound words. Okay student, and you have to do this given homework, that is how do you think the poet feels about her grandmother. Give reason for your answer. Okay student, so that's it for today. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy and keep watching my video. Thank you.